Rated T for Teen.
Should you spread out your uploads evenly over time? Some viewers really like to binge through content all at once, like a whole series. Whereas other viewers, they're not going to watch all your new uploads at the same time. Our discovery system aims to enable both of these cases, depending on the viewer's preferences. So there's no single approach that's going to work for all channels. Try uploading more frequently.
I'm going to bust that myth.
My videos aren't sending out properly to the sub boxes. YouTube is broken.
You're right, Felix. YouTube is broken. The thing I've seen time and time again is the belief that the YouTube sub box is broken. Verbal shorthand for the fear that if you're a subscriber to a channel, say the Game Theorists, you aren't being notified on your homepage of our latest video. But also big stuff too, like how frequently a channel should upload, which, when you think about it, is a pretty complicated question. You never get negative views on a video, so uploading more videos should get you more views, right? Except that's not always the case. For some channels, I've gone in and recommended cutting half the programming and seen the number of views double with half the videos. It seems impossible, right? And it would be if it weren't for a phenomenon I like to call subscriber burn. The reason why channels can have millions of subscribers, but sometimes have a really hard time getting a tenth of those people to actually watch their videos. Let me explain using another website you might have heard of, Facebook. Facebook is what I was going for. On Facebook, you see lots of notifications in your feed from your local friends, people you regularly hang out with, people who put up infuriating political arguments that you just have to rebut, or cute cat pictures that you just want to print out and snuggle with on your bed. And while I have thousands of friends on Facebook, I don't see most of the posts everyone is making. Why? Well, I've had a lot of those friends for a long time, most of them coming from high school and college, and although they're posting something every day, Facebook is filtering them out for me because they know I haven't engaged with those people, or more accurately, engaged with their posts for a long time. To Facebook's algorithms, this means that their stuff isn't relevant to me, doesn't interest me anymore, so it stops showing them to me. Or look at it from the other side. A few months ago, every other post was something like top 7 marriage proposal, and that's because everyone and their grandmother literally wanted to find out what sort of musical dance number, ice sculpture thing this veritable King of Hearts had done to lock down that number 4 position. So everyone who saw that post would click on it. Highly engaging post, more people see it, and all of a sudden my friend who posted that thing jumps to the top of my feed every day. By clicking that one article, I told Facebook that my close friend was posting content I was interested in, and they took it as their chance to open the floodgates and show me all of her stuff. At least until I stopped engaging. So that's a lot about Facebook. From what I found, YouTube works the same way. Just replace the word friend with subscriber. If you click on every Game Theorist video, our notifications will appear at the top of your feeds when we have a new video. Bonus points if you like and comment. You're telling YouTube this is a channel you're very interested in. But if you only click on the show Digressing and SideQuest, which uploads like once a year at this point, a long time will pass between uploads that interest you, and by the time Ronnie's and pumps out a new video a year from now, you're not gonna see it. Too much time will have passed, and YouTube will have decided that you no longer want to see our uploads since you didn't click on them. You're still a subscriber, but you've become a defunct or burned out subscriber. This all makes sense, right? YouTube is like a dating service. It's their job to give people the best experience on the platform possible, and so they want to show you stuff that's most interesting and engaging for you. Visibility on the homepage is limited, so they want to only deliver the stuff that's got a high probability of getting you to click. It's a pretty smart solution to the problem of so much stuff being uploaded to YouTube every day. I mean, it certainly makes it hard for us creators because it basically forces us to constantly be creative and produce more videos. You don't get a vacation on YouTube, because once you go for more than 2 weeks without an upload, you're starting to put your channel at risk. But still, lots of websites do this filtering technique, so it's not earth-shattering stuff. But here's where the YouTube situation starts to get complicated. It's not just on a time basis, but also on a per video basis. And this is where PewDiePie's broken sub box comes in. PewDiePie produces tons of videos, at least one a day, which gets him an enormous amount of views and subscribers. But it's also really hard for subscribers to keep up. For even the most dedicated of bros, 100 minutes a week of Maya, Marzia, and fisting is a lot to watch. So they end up skipping videos, missing them, while Felix keeps working his little pink headphones off to keep them flowing out. At a certain point, between the new new uploads that Pewds is pushing out and the ones that the true bro has missed or skipped, they hit a certain percentage of watched to unwatched videos, and YouTube determines that the subscriber is no longer interested in the channel's content, which results in PewDiePie's videos no longer appearing in their notifications. Here, it's not a problem of time, but a problem of engagement. Because of the amount of new content PewDiePie is producing every week, he burns through his subscribers faster. His total subscriber number stays the same, but only about 30% of that 32 million are actually seeing notifications from the Pewds. Let me illustrate with something a little closer to home. The show you're watching right now, Game Theory. But with each episode taking around 100 hours to make, crazy, right? I can only produce these videos so fast. All the other shows on the channel help me out between uploads, but they just don't get the number of clicks as this series. Which means that I need to stay constantly aware of how many culture shocks, smash histories, etc. I upload in between Game Theories. If I do too many, you guys won't see that next episode of GT in your feed. You'll have been burned out by the YouTube algorithm. Even within Game Theory, for every few episodes I do on mobile games, indie games, or something more obscure, I make sure to keep everything balanced with some big games, Nintendo titles, since those are the ones that everyone can relate to and will check out. I've structured the release schedule on this channel in such a way that we can try new and different things, but also try to make sure that there's enough for everyone so that you stay an active subscriber rather than a burned out one. And thus, the mystery of the sub box is solved.